Hello, I'm Ashley with Uniquely Yours Home, and today we are doing part three of our room by room challenge, and we're going over everything office. So I'm joining you today from our office that we do everything for Uniquely Yours out of. When we talk about offices, one of the most important things that you'll hear me say repeatedly during this video is function. This is a space where function can really trump design. It's more important for this space to function for you to work out of than to have it be a space that just looks pretty, but you can't get anything done. And a lot of times you can marry those two ideas together and create something that is functional, but is still pleasing to the eye. So the first thing that we want to talk about is editing and organizing the space and defining what you really need this space to be. We feel that most people have fall into three categories of their home office. So either it's used for personal use only, kids may do their homework here, you could write out bills, and just a place for you to have your computer. This may be in an actual room or maybe out in a common living space. Another function of a home office is someone working for another company from home. So they do all of their work mainly from home and they have an office area set up for that. And third is someone conducting their own business. So running their business from their home office and doing their administrative work or conducting their entire business out of their home office. So usually people fall into one of three of those categories. But really when it comes to starting in your office, they all have the same common idea. Edit what you don't need in the space and figure out what you do and how you need to store it. So recently, we redid this office. It used to be in my lower level and then we decided to bring it up to our main level. We went through and decided what documents we needed to keep, what ones could go into storage, and really defined how much drawer space, how much cabinet space that we needed in this area. From there, we then designed the cabinets that you see behind me. We also talked about workspace. How much workspace do we need? We decided to use a table. That way, either Donna and I could sit across from each other or we could have multiple people at the desk, or if we had to sit next to each other, that table really provided the most functionality. In another case, someone might need to have more storage in their desk because they can't get it from other areas of the room. So then you want to look for more of a desk style that has more storage. So really, what is the function of the space? Decide what needs to be in it and go from there when you're planning the design of it. So the other aspect of organizing is also cleaning. So you want to take this room from top to bottom, just like we were suggested with the bathroom. You want to start at the light fixture, clean the light fixture. There's furniture that's been against the wall for a long time. Pull that out, wipe the wall down, and clean off all your surfaces. Wipe down the computer screen, wipe down that keyboard, get all those nooks and crannies, and then wipe down baseboard, woodwork, all that type of thing. So organizing, editing, cleaning, and then the last part is making it look pretty. When you're in an office and you're in it a lot and you're spending a lot of time in it, we feel that it's important to have things that inspire you. So as you can see behind me, we have some family pictures, we have a favorite quote, we also have some greens. Those greens are actually, we got those pots from the dollar store a few years ago and they worked great. Another thing that we have are some rocks from some of Donna's and mine vacations. Just simple things like that that bring us joy. On the other side that you can't see, each one of us also has a whiteboard. We call that our why. So this is something we suggest a little bit more for small business owners, but really could work for anybody. When you're in an office, what is your why? Why are you working so hard in this space? And so we have family pictures or vacation pictures of places we want to go back to, quotes that kind of get us motivated when we are having trouble getting going that day. So what is your why? I think that's a really important thing to have in your office. It's directly across from our desk, so we look up and we see it, and it kind of just helps, you know, grease the wheels a little bit on a hard day. Another thing to think about, which I mentioned earlier when decorating office, is to try to marry function and design. So if you could use decorative baskets or bins, or even if you can see behind me, I have a drawer that we put thank you cards in. So marrying that function and design together, you can get something that is pleasing to the eye, but also provides storage or any other functional needs that you need in this space. So to recap, edit, organize the space first. Determine what you need and what type of storage. Is it drawer? Is it file storage? Is it things that can be put away in storage? What needs to be in that space? You don't want to overclutter your office space. This is a space where you need to think and be creative at times, or it takes a lot of brain power to be in this space. You don't want to be bogged down by things that you no longer need and are no longer serving you. The second thing is cleaning all the areas top to bottom. And last, make it look pretty. Add some greens, add some things that inspire you. That's different for everybody. So what do you need this office to feel? Does it need to be that motivational kick in the butt that you need, or someplace pretty and a retreat so that you can think creatively in your job? So stay tuned for more room by room ideas. The next room we are going into is kids' rooms.